The life of an animal is simple. Their only goal is to survive long enough to reproduce. Humans are animals too, however, our lives have become far more complicated than that. Every year, a few thousand people take a step back from society and leave behind the stress and expectations of their previous lives and jobs. Some take leave and won't be gone long, however, some won't come back at all. These few thousand people face the 6-to-1 odds and attempt to walk the 2,200 miles of the Appalachian Trail from Georgia to Maine, through the cold, the wind, the rain, and the heat, until only a few hundred hardy souls remain. And these few, through grit and determination, earn the privilege of calling themselves thru-hikers. My name's Matheson, but out here everyone calls me Bear, like the animal. This is what it was like for me to attempt an Appalachian thru-hike in 2018.
You can see why so many people quit right at the start, because I think I just went the wrong way. Yeah, I totally did. Yeah, dude, it was just like 500 steps, like straight up, so I can see why people quit, but I'm not gonna quit just yet. I'm singing this song, but if you're too dumb, when it's gone.
So they say there's 4,000 people going to try and thru-hike the Appalachian Trail this year. And they said that Neil's Gap, which is where I am now, is where 1,000 people quit. I didn't believe them, and I looked up at this tree.
Throughout my whole life, I've tried to remove failure from the equation as much as I could. People sometimes ask me what's plan B, and I always say the same thing. There really is no plan B, but plan A is pretty solid. And so completing my Appalachian thru-hike was just a prime example of that. Alright, so this spot here, super, super important, because 3 years ago in 2015, me and a couple of people working at Camp Luema, but me and a couple of people came out here and went camping, and between this tree and this tree right here, we set up two hammocks. I was in the top story, so I was in this exact same spot when three hikers walked past, and this is where I decided that I wanted to hike the Appalachian Trail. So three people went past, they were skinny, two dudes and a chick, they were skinny, the dudes had beards, the woman a little bit too. Their legs were super jacked, they were real thin, and I gave them like a huge wave, I was like, yay! It was like 5 o'clock in the morning, and they just looked at me and gave me the tiniest little energy saving nod, and I was like, man, that's hardcore. I was like, damn, that's hardcore, this guy's gonna walk the whole thing. I was like, I reckon I could do that. That was 3 years ago in this exact same spot right now. Before I went to America, I spent 2 years at university training as an outdoor instructor, and the whole time knowing that I wanted to hike, I wanted to do a thru-hike in 2018. So trying to pay my way through university and save enough money for an Appalachian thru-hike wasn't a super easy thing to do, but with a little bit of creativity and a fair bit of grit, you can basically do whatever you want. That did mean I was homeless for a whole year while at uni, and then I had to live out of my van for 4.5 months, eating nothing but canned chickpeas and fruit. But if that's the price I had to pay, then it's a price I'd pay twice over. Day three. There's like a big risk of like bear attacks and stuff that have been in this next area. So because of that, you got to take a beer canister. I don't have a beer canister, but there's possibly like a beer box. So hopefully, I'm thinking pretty positively about it, but now I hike alone, and I left all my friends behind, but I guess we'll see. To fit to her lifestyle. Do 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 do. She's swiping left and right, she double clicks that screen. She'll change her profile pic, she'll use her maiden name. Big one, dude. That could eat like big rats. You know, like rats the size of small dogs.
Here in the wild,
Now, subjecting your body to rapid temperature fluctuations can be incredibly hazardous and bad for you. But I've been sweating my ring piece out for the past 3 hours, so I've long since given up on caring about whether I live or die.
This pack of wolves comes right up to camp. I was in my tent, everyone was like, was asleep when they started, and they just start howling and like yelping and like fighting outside. Dude, we're talking like 60 meters from camp, they're just like howling. She liked them
most disappointing border crossing in my whole friggin' life.
So yeah, so the North Carolina border crossing was terrible, man. I'm not saying I was expecting some guy to be standing there like congratulating me and like to shake my hand, but it would have been nice, you know. Alright, so we're up here in the mountains and it just started snowing and hailing. I swear it just stopped just before the camera went on, but I put on my most waterproof outfit. I got my granny gloves and rain hat. But yeah, hopefully it starts hailing again so I can prove that I'm not just lying. I'm a man on my knees. So it's like big time cold, real cold. But yeah, got the fire lit in there, collecting firewood. It's gonna be a pretty cold night, but I don't know, this is the Smokies, I guess, night one in the Smokies. Oh, it's snowing. But the hair on my legs is frozen. It's all white and like crystallized. Yeah, that's the hair on my legs. Pretty frozen. No, I'm kind of enjoying it. I'm having a good time. This morning was pretty crazy. Woke up a bit earlier than normal. Woke up at 6. Pretty cold night. And I pulled back the tarpaulin and everything's just white. Everything's so white. There's like icicles up in the trees and like snow all over the ground. It's pretty wild. Alright, so I'm hiking here with Crux, Creeks, and Rocket Man's still alive back there somewhere, I think. It stopped snowing, but all our hair's frozen, but I kind of like it. But yeah, we're coming up to the highest point on the Appalachian Trail at 6,600 feet. 6,600 something feet, so yeah, looking forward to seeing absolutely nothing because of all the snow, but it's okay. And as we walk out of North Carolina into Tennessee, the nomadic lifestyle wasn't just starting to feel normal, it was starting to feel really good. The body was ready to get up and walk, and so were we. Alright, so it's been a big couple of days. We're hiking, came across this like snake, it's gotta be like 2 meters long right across the track. Excuse me, that was pretty good. And then we got into town. I slept on the floor, got tasered twice, which was really good. Filming, we got scrambled legs there. Introduce yourself.
What's up, scrambled legs? How's it going?
Little did I know that this scruffy dude sitting under the bridge with me was about to become my best friend. Things are going pretty good. It's heating up. It's nice. Climate's good. Everybody thought we were leaving the cold weather behind us, but everybody was wrong. Frozen pond, my favorite. Oh, okay, it's not that thick. Or is it? Whoa, Oh! Okay, it's not thick enough to walk on. Shivers. I better leave here before I like injure myself. And come across something fantastic. Even more so than my hat. And it's this thing here. This is a bag. It's literally the reason I chose the Appalachian Trail over PCT, pretty much, one second. Is because they do this thing called trail magic, which is where they just put bags of like cool stuff like this. Dude, Dr. Peppers, man. Oh, so good. So people just put bags of food along the trail. This is just drinks, but man.
I got a friend in Baltimore, little Liza Jane. Streetcars running by her door, little Liza Jane. Oh, little Liza Jane. Oh, little Liza Jane.
You got chips, some fruit, I had a banana. I don't know what corn nuts are, but I'm sure they're good. You got Chips Ahoy, all sorts of good stuff in there. Got told that there's the best trail magic I'm ever gonna experience. Ooh, they look like they bite, in my life. And it is coming up. Oh, hang on, this people, I better put this down.
Feel those cold winds blow, little Liza Jane. Oh, little Liza Jane.
Mom, do you remember when I told you when I moved out I was gonna drink Coke and eat chocolate for breakfast?
Megan, you want your sandwich in here?
Yeah, I can put it in there. Thank you so much. You're awesome.
9 a.m. Easter morning.
I got a friend in Kansas City, little Liza Jane. Where those girls are all so pretty, little Liza Jane.
I'm gonna get out of the shot.
You are the shot.
I am it. Not empty, which is amazing. So people just leave stuff out like this. There's always a book so you can sign it. Everyone just says like thanks and stuff like that. But that's what it's like to get trail magic out here. So we're just going down some hill, and then we see a chili bin at the bottom. It's got some like muesli bars in it. I haven't had breakfast yet because I don't have any water. And some like little juice drinks, apple juice drinks, so I had one of them. Then you go past a plastic bag with candy in it, I'm like, hang on. And then we see the sign for the place that was giving away like free cheeseburgers. I started giggling and running like a little girl across the road. So hopefully, coming up to the park, and we're hoping that they're set up in there. Otherwise, we've already walked past it, which would break my heart.
Oh, little Liza, little Liza Jane. Little Liza Jane.
I gotta check out, see if we can actually get up under this bridge to sleep. It's super steep. Oh, it's steep. Someone's been pissing in here. Yo. I mean, you wouldn't want to roll over in the night, but I can make this work. So here we are in the best stealth camp so far. Scrambled Eggs is up there cooking some... cooking up some taters. I'm having a cheese wrap. It's pretty chill. Apart from the consistent noise of trucks using their engine brakes and cars going real fast. But... Sweet. So it's me and Scrambled Legs.
What's up?
And we've been weaving in and out of North Carolina and Tennessee for ages now. But we're finally leaving North Carolina for the last time. See you later, North Carolina. It's been a blast. There it is. Coming up to the line. Oh!
it is. There, it's North Carolina. That's Tennessee. Send me, I gave me my distance from long-term leases. I
wanted a dog, but I never got one. There we go. Tennessee / Virginia state line. You ready? Oh, there's even a line of rocks. How cute is that? The wild horses of Virginia. This is Virginia Highlands, I guess. We've been climbing pretty consistently for the past little while. It's been kind of flat out because we're trying to beat everybody else to the shelter. But here we got a bunch of wild horses. There's some wild horses. There's some more wild horses. It's another wild horse. Almost nothing that I couldn't give up. I could do almost anything I wanted. I could drive down to Mexico, Mount Yon. I found myself wishing I had a little more. How you
feeling there?
We're sitting here on hollow ground. I'd heard of the stories, but I didn't know it was real until today. This is an all-you-can-eat KFC buffet. Now, personally, I feel disgusting, but I'm going back for thirds. I already hate myself, but I'm going back for thirds, so wish me luck, dude. I can feel my arteries clogging up. So it doesn't look superficial or anything, but nothing around here does. It's quarter of the way. So quarter of the way done, I guess. So that's about it. So it's me and old mate Legs here, day 44, things are going alright. We looked at our food and we're like, oh, we can skip over that next town, like we can push our food rations. So food rations have been like real tight, and then I go and like mess up my leg real bad. So now I really need to stop, but if I stop we'll starve because we've got no food. So. Uphills are okay in the morning, downhills are not so good, so I really need to take a rest day, but we just can't because there's no food. So there's only so much pain you can go through and still finish the day with a smile on your face. I'm getting pretty close to that limit with this being day 3.5. We were at the table by the window with the view, casting shadows, the sun was pushing through. Spoke a lot of words, I don't know if I spoke the truth. Got so much to do, got so much to prove. God, don't let me lose. So it's been an interesting little while. Me and Legs sitting on the side of the road. He's having a nap. We came into the town Daleville. So my knee's real pretty bad, so we're waiting on the side of the road. Legs' dad's coming to pick us up, take us back to Baltimore. Maybe we'll check out Washington, D.C. I don't know, do whatever you do when you can't walk. And then we'll come back after a couple of days and keep going. That or I'm sucked and my leg's buggered and it's over, but hopefully that's not the case. So we take a couple of days off and then come back and carry on. During the 6 days we spent at Scrambled Legs' house, we ate about as much food as two humans could possibly eat and then prepped for future trails.
Do you think you have enough food?
Makes me hungry just looking at it. During one of the rest days, we thought we'd better get out and do something, so we went into DC to have a look around. And then we checked the bus times and tried to figure ourselves a way back to Damascus for trail days. All right, so it's been pretty rough lately. We did our 12-hour bus ride back from Scrambled Legs' house. That was really good. It's nothing like a 12-hour bus ride in the middle of the night. But yeah, now we're walking to the visitor center, hopefully gonna hitch the trail days. Alright, so me and Legs here, we're back in Damascus, Virginia. Day early for trail days, but it's getting pretty busy already. Everyone's setting up. All their vendors and stuff like that, so free pack repairs, piss ups. Should be all go. How are you feeling about the competition this year?
Confident.
Alright, so haven't done one of these for probably a week or something now. I was going to say things have been good, but they really haven't. We went into a town, my knee was pretty sore, tried to do too much, so we had to go into town, we zeroed there. We went to the Ming's buffet, that was pretty, I mean, it was an experience. It was a good experience. We ate till I blacked out and he threw up outside.
Oh, it's all part of the it's all part of the Ming's experience. Oh, dude, we gotta go. We gotta leave.
So I started having a third person experience while I was in there. It was getting out of control. Yeah, we're sitting and then I'm like, dude, I don't feel too good. And I thought I was gonna black out at the table, but we managed to get outside and then I lay down and passed out. But then, yeah, after that, for a multitude of different reasons, I was having some really tough times. Feet were getting ripped to shreds. It was bad. Things were bad. Well, it's sunny now, so that's good. Yeah, did things lighten up or a little?
No,
I still feel pretty bad. Yeah, so we're nearly out of Virginia, so I guess that's good news. My knee's still bad, so that's a contributing factor. But yeah, I mean, things really haven't got too much better. It's a bit of a grind lately. Yeah. So we're coming up to Front Royal and getting close to getting out of Virginia. Dude, if I never see Virginia again, I'll be stoked. Okay, so turns out Leg was way more messed up than we thought, so it's been pretty, we've started trying to hike on it again, it's been pretty, we're not walking very fast, not walking very far, and it doesn't really feel like it's healing that much, so we're trying to figure out what I can do to sort of ease the strain on my knee, and I came up with an idea, and that's to get rid of both my tent and my sleeping bag. Now, there's two ways to go ultralight. You can either buy more lightweight versions of what you've already got, or you can just get rid of the things that you more or less don't need. So I'm getting rid of my tent, my sleeping bag, and now I know what you're thinking. You're sitting at home in front of your computer or on your phone, you're like, dude, that's a stupid idea. That's a friggin' stupid thing to do, you know? Like, you're so Matheson, you're so dumb, dude, what an idiot. But I will tell you this. You're absolutely right. This is one of the dumbest things I've ever done. And keep in mind, I let someone taser me twice in the same day. So I know it's a terrible idea, But if it's gonna help me get to Katahdin and finish this hike, I'm willing to do it. I'm feeling pretty good. I'm feeling
confident.
Yeah, I mean, you could use a different adjective, but I'm feeling something. Could just be hunger, but I'm feeling something, but yeah.
It's where Legs sleeps in the hammock. I'm just an animal, so I sleep on the ground like an animal. But it's gonna be a cold night.
So how'd you sleep last night, Legs?
It's great.
You warm enough?
Yeah, it was perfect.
I'm happy to hear that.
I woke up outside in the dirt. I wasn't warm enough, but I lived.
That's 800 miles. That's what you want.
No, it's 9:30 in the morning, walking again, but today's different because today's the day that we walk out of Virginia for the last time now.
Cool.
All right, so we're leaving Virginia for the final time. I thought I'd give a quick toast, so it's my drink. Virginia, it's appropriate we leave you on this stony ass, bumpy ass part because, you know, you've had your ups and downs. Yeah. Wore the tips off my poles, you blistered my feet, you mucked up my leg, and you've darkened my heart. Now I would normally say, because seeing as I'm trying to learn to speak German, bis später, but seeing as though hopefully I never ever see the state again, and if I do, I want you to punch me in the neck, I'm going to simply say, I'm out of water. All right. Okay, so We're bouncing in and out of West Virginia all the time, but we're still sticking to the rule of making sure that we listen to country roads for the entire time that we hike through West Virginia. And so I think we just crossed the line, so you want to hit that, my friend? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Heaven. West Virginia.
Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong.
It's 7:50. It's 7:55. It's pretty early to be listening to country roads again, but we're still zigzagging in and out of Virginia and West Virginia. Coming up very soon, we leave Virginia for the final time, and I can't wait. But the only problem with that is it means we have to listen to this non-stop until we leave West Virginia.
Mama, take me home.
Well, there's only so much of country roads you can listen to before you truly wish for the end. But West Virginia's already over, so it's that one, Maryland, and it's Maryland. Sweet, it's nice. I feel good about it. It's got to be day 82 or something. Very special day.
We're
gonna try and eat 2 liters of ice cream at, you know, 9 o'clock in the morning. It's only 9 now, so we'll be a little bit later then. So we're here at the Fabled Ice Cream Challenge place. A couple of battlers nearly there.
Okay, introduce yourself, boys.
I am Frick.
And I'm Frack.
These guys going pretty hard.
they're done with their first one. You got to eat one of these.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, one of those.
Three pints of this, one more pint of this.
Yeah, so they both.
And then we'll be finished.
These guys have gone for the added challenge and bought a large chips as well, large fries. So, yeah, how's it going? Is it good?
Going great. It is awesome.
I'm about to do it. Okay.
All right. So, rules of the challenge: you got 1 hour. Oh, dude, it's. You're gonna struggle with this one. You got 1 hour to eat one of these and then one of those Pepsi cups for the ice cream. That's pretty much it. Get started.
Munching down on that.
It's fun getting this.
It's not pleasant.
It's not pleasant.
I'm actually still enjoying it though on the stage.
Well, Legs, you finished the challenge. How do you feel? What do you got there?
This is all you get.
Look at all you pacing around with your ice cream. Pace together, get closer.
It's making it work.
Real ice cream, real vomit. Yeah, just wait. You guys want to see it?
Please don't.
You want to see it?
So not hiker etiquette.
So we're walking along here. Legs behind me. He, unfortunately, he did manage to beat me. Ate his ice cream 10 minutes faster, but I feel fantastic. How do you feel, man? Who's laughing now? I feel good. This
54 cents. 54 cents well spent.
Hey Legs, how's the haircut going?
I highly recommend this barber.
Now let me show you my favorite part here. It's been this way. So we've gone for sort of like a balding sort of look, but we left him with a bit of style here. And also he's been a little bit further. He's obviously got the Aussie mullet, which he's gonna rock. I told him it works wonders with the ladies, so he's certainly into that.
How do you like it? I think it looks good.
It looks good.
It's quite bubbly.
Drink yourself,
All right, so here we are at this train track. This one here, you see this? This train track here, it's hot. It's matte in the middle. This is slightly more special than all the other train tracks because it's the Mason-Dixon line. This cuts America in half, basically. So that's pretty cool.
Mason-Dixon, Maryland, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, that's it. Now we're in Pennsylvania. Cool. Okay, so Pennsylvania, well known for the rocks. You know, it's pretty hot today and we're thoroughly enjoying it. I'm getting tendonitis in my leg. Feels good. How do you feel about it?
I love it.
I love it.
Look how hard it is. It just goes on and on. And the map says elevation wise it's like this 15 miles with no water. So I certainly haven't got enough, but I've got some.
Alright, so as you can see, we've got these large open fields just here. We've been walking through them on and off all day, and it's hot. Big time hot. Now, the last thing you need here is sunburn, right? So I haven't got a sun hat with me, and by that I mean it's deep in my pack. What I have got is my t-shirt here. What we're gonna do is the old t-shirt turban. You just chuck it over your head like you're gonna put on a normal t-shirt. That'd be a normal t-shirt, right? Wrong. Put it over there like that. You take your sleeves. There's one. It smells awful in here. There's the other one. And you sort of just pull it tight and tie it at the back. Now, if you're looking for true sun safety, you can urinate on it to keep your head cool. But as you can see, now if I step into the sun, I'm perfectly sun smart, and it's actually ideal for a whole variety of things. You've got snatch and grabs at your local dairy, you know, gang affiliated crimes, hit and runs, home intrusions, general theft, and aggravated robbery. That's perfect. So now I'm feeling pretty good. Once I wrap on some sunnies, there we go. Absolutely sun smart. You know, I'm walking in here, and as you can see, there's not a single part of my body that's gonna be burnt now. I haven't got any urine, but I have got the last of my water for the next 10 or so miles, so just splash a bit over that over there for whatever reason. I don't know why you do that, but you can. Drink a little bit through your sweatshirt. That tastes like sweat. It's awesome, everything's good. Carry on this way. I hear a voice calling out. These shackles I made in the town to be free. So we were hiking along back there in crippling pain, and I stopped to take some of the rocks out of my shoe and noticed that I've completely lost the feeling in three of my toes. So taking out the inserts that were already in the shoe, chucked in some Dr. Scholl's. I'm counting on you, Dr. Scholl. Help me, please. Please help me. Been nearly 24 miles of chronic foot pain and dehydration. Pretty thirsty, very hungry. I can't even imagine what my feet look like. Well, it's the morning of. It's the summer solstice, 21st. Yeah, and Legs and I are doing it after a brief period of full exposure. We've decided to hang the rags. This is Pennsylvania, that'd be New Jersey. We got 995.6 miles to go. Pretty stoked. Are you ready? Pennsylvania.
My man!
Never in my life. Never coming back. Alright.
Well, dude, 100 miles in 4 days.
Yeah. Yeah, man, that's...
Dude, do you want this?
That's good. So we're here, Katahdin, only 500 miles away. So to celebrate, I'm eating the most nutritious food you can get out here on the AT, which is a Little Debbie strawberry fruit roll. I wanted one of these for 1,500. How far have we gone?
17.
I've wanted one of these for about 1,500 miles, so it tastes like sweet, sweet cholesterol problems for the future. Just gotta do 20 miles today, and then I got a friend gonna pick me and legs up, and we're gonna take a couple, 2 days off. That's the plan. I sort of get restless, but we haven't taken days off for a long time now. Now, in my mind, to rest kind of sounds like to do nothing. I'm not a big fan of doing nothing, so if we weren't gonna be hiking, we were gonna be doing something.
And after the broiest of all brofists, it was time to get back out there. It was 500 miles to go, and the miles weren't going to hike themselves.
Is all your stuff dry?
I mean, the boots are still a little bit damp, but the socks are good to go.
Alright, well, we're coming up to the Vermont-New Hampshire border crossing. There's this bridge just up here, so we're about to leave Vermont, going to New Hampshire.
There it is. You can barely see it. Vermont-New Hampshire.
Yo!
Ready?
Alright, so we're in this fire tower.
Here we are. Windows. Windows.
Home, this is where we're sleeping
tonight.
A
homeless person.
It's true.
Windows. Windows. Sunset.
It's been a long time coming. I'll be getting closer and closer to the whites for a long time now, and knowing full well that when we got here it's gonna be steep, and it is. So yeah, I mean, it's early in the morning and I'm climbing up the start of a steep ass mountain, so welcome to the whites. Pretty windy. You love to feel offended. All right, so we're climbing our third and final 4,000 foot peak of the day. So it's been a pretty big day. You got a semi-automatic car. Go easy now. Hey, it's so low, hey, it's so low, hey, it's so low. We got Mount Washington coming up. Is it the second tallest peak on the AT, dude? It's a tall peak, but anyway, we've heard that people are actually going over. they're making it over. We also got told that one of the guys went up there and the wind was so strong he was thrown onto his hands and knees, which is pretty funny, and then the wind picked him up and flipped him like a pancake onto his back, and like wrecked him a little bit. But we're gonna be going over that in like, I don't know, 2.5 hours or something, so I'm actually really excited about it. Woo! Okay, so it's quite cold, it's quite windy, it's very wet. These are my hands. People don't even want to see my feet, that turns this into an R18. Anyway, so we're just heading up Mount Washington now. And just as a friendly reminder, we've come across a sign here. Stop. The area here has the worst weather in America. Many have died there from exposure, even in the summer. Turn back now if the weather is bad. But bad is the subjective term, and I'm feeling good. So, you know, with that in mind, we're going to do as fast as we possibly can.
Of the weather behind us, and having completed the whites, the hardest terrain on the AT, it was looking like it was going to be a straight shot all the way to Katahdin. Feels like to never come back again.
This look healthy foot to you?
Show us the other one. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's disgusting, man. It's all slimy. It's slimy. Touch it. It's like it's all slimy. Give it a touch.
I'm not touching it.
It's extremely itchy. It's itchy. It's painful. It stinks. It's disgusting, dude. It's disgusting. From all the rain, this is basically what the trail is now. Just soaking wet and carries on down. So good luck keeping your shoes dry. We're not gonna fix the gangrene problem today. Trench foot is here to stay. I wanna love her in my heart and never come back again. Insane. Okay. So have a look at this. Looks like a wall barricade, right? Holding back a whole lot of water. But how did it get here? You might be asking. Well, I'll tell you, the truth is stranger than fiction. Beavers built it with their bare little beaver hands in their mouths. Look at this, look how much wood there is. How do they do it, man? How do they do it? It's huge, it's massive. And look, most of the wood looks like it's not even doing anything. Look, what is this? What is this? You know, you can't play with it too much or the beavers will come out and get you. But the thing is, if I break a small part of this, which I'm not gonna do, as funny as it would be, but if I pull something off, look at the size of that log! Look at the size of that friggin' log, it's as thick as my torso. Not that my torso's very thick. Tell me how the beavers moved that one. Do you see that? I'm gonna point to it.
This one here. Can you tell me how a 3 kilo beaver, or however much they weigh, moved that tree? Unbelievable, dude. Every single time I see it, it just blows my mind. They chewed these ones. Have a look at this. Come over this way. Look at this. See this? The beavers chewed this with their little beaver teeth. Surely not. I don't know how they do it, man. Oh, yeah. And if you break a little part of this, the beavers will come out and fix it. Probably they'll probably come out and get you, and then they'll come out and fix it. Unbelievable. And it's crazy that no one's ever seen a beaver. You know, no one's ever seen one doing this. Unbelievable. Blows my mind. Beavers. Unbelievable. Never come back again. I wanna see the end of a world.
something's made me pretty sick. Could be food poisoning, but it'd have to be some pretty nasty food. But it's most likely from drinking some contaminated water. It's pretty bad. Oh, dude, this is bad. I was rapidly starting to realize it was something bad, but I did not know yet just how bad. It's not good. Okay, so it's the 2nd of August. It's also the 8th day that I've been sick. Have this motto. I say if you get injured or sick or you know hurt or whatever, give it 3 days. If it's not better in 3 days, give it 5. If it's not better in 5, give it a week. If it's not better in a week, accept it as your new normal and carry on from that point. So I guess the constant nausea and you know all that, you know, good stuff, so that's the new normal now. But with only, well, it was 8 days if I was fast. I'm not sure if I feel very fast at the moment, but still was hoping to be on the summit of Katahdin in 8 days. Read it out.
Symptoms are usually mild and include watery, malodorous diarrhea, abdominal cramps and distension, flatulence, intermittent nausea.
Oh, I've got it bad, man.
Acute.
I've got it bad.
Giardia usually lasts 1 to 3 weeks.
Oh my goodness.
Treatment is antibiotic, antibiotic, or antibiotic.
Is there like a fourth, just like deal with it option?
No.
So I'm not going to get better unless I get antibiotics.
You might. Not for 3 weeks, though.
Well, what are we supposed to do? There's no friggin' doctors out here. I think I can deal with it. It's just 21 miles a day. For 8 days. Lucky me!
So it was starting to look like I'd contracted the dreaded stomach parasite. But not only did I have Giardia, but I had also contracted E. coli. And without medicine, the next 8 days were about to be the hardest 8 days of the entire Appalachian Trail.
Coming up to a road so we can hitch into Monson. Monson is the last town on the AT, the last town before the 100 mile wilderness. So we're gonna hitch in there, grab some goods. After this, it's literally one final push all the way there. No places to obtain supplies. It's 100 miles. Do not attempt the section unless you have a minimum of 10 days supply. It's difficult and should not be underestimated. So basically it's saying if you're a little bit of a pussy, you might have a problem. Or if you've got giardia and a bung there, you could have a problem as well. Yeah. Don't underestimate it, man. Don't underestimate it, man. Spooky stuff, man. 100 miles of wilderness, man. Spooky stuff. Spooky stuff. All right, let's get the hell out of here.
4 days until I'm standing at the summit.
So it's the 8th of August, which means tomorrow
It's the last full day of hiking. And then we're climbing Katahdin. But man, we're coming Katahdin.
Now, one of the most cruel symptoms of giardia is your inability to process foods, meaning starvation. And this was certainly something that I was experiencing. But at this stage in the game, there wasn't a single thing on this earth that was gonna stop me.
I've walked 2,200 miles from Georgia to Maine. And tomorrow, day 139, is the last day.
It's 4:45.
Today is the day. Let's get started. Miles to go. And my whole body is buzzing. My heart's all fluttery. And I can't tell if it's because every hardship, every day with not enough food, every night with not enough sleep, if all of it winding down to this one single day is making my whole body go crazy. That or it's just the detrimental health problems caused by the Red Bull I just drank, or the giardia, which has had a serious impact on my health. It's one of the three.
Now they say that trying to fuel your body off sugar alone is like trying to warm your house by burning nothing but newspaper in your fireplace. And they're probably right, but on a day like today, I say, let it burn.
Now exhausted states, we pushed on, onwards and upwards, into the clouds and into the cold. And after 139 days of looking up and picturing that sign on my head, I looked up and there it was. Last 4.5 months is a strange thing to do. I saw so much in a short period of time. I saw a sparse brown forest turn slowly into a lush green paradise. I saw branches encased in ice, and when the wind blew, I saw a million diamonds fall from the sky. I saw an abundance of life, and I saw the forest fires burn the trees black. I saw how people's lives have been changed by the trail, and I saw people repaying the trail in any way they could. I saw the kindness of others, and it's something I'll never forget. Not everybody makes it, nor should they. And out of the few that do, all of them in their own way are changed, humbled, or renewed. Some of the people who finish will make a radical change in their lives with a newfound appreciation for the things they previously took for granted, like a hot shower, cold drinking water, and a decent meal. But for a lot of them, over time, this appreciation will fade and they'll slowly return to their old jobs, their old habits, and eventually their old ways of life. But not me. And why not? Oh, because there's something wrong with me. Well, how you like me now? What's next?
Well, how you like me now? How you like me now?
You look good.
How you like me now? Well, how you like me now?
Remember the time.
Yeah.